that was a heck of a football game, a hard-fought game on both sides, and Tennessee played their hearts out. They came out in the first half and gave us a lot of issues defensively with some different things they did. They game-planned us extremely well, in my opinion. They got the ball on the perimeter. We did not tackle very well in the first half, but really settled down in the red zone. We made stops in the red zone. When you play with good red zone defense, it's going to give you a chance to win ball games. We made some really good adjustments offensively in the second half, a nine-minute scoring drive, a six-minute scoring drive. We ran the ball extremely well in the second half against a front that's very difficult to move inside. We've got really good inside players, so extremely proud of that, the three linemen down. But, you know, the heart of our football team shows up again, the culture of our program, the way those guys continue to fight and willed it out. We busted coverage on the long pass there at the end. We need to stay in the middle of the field. We don't. The quarterback's able to buy time, get the ball down the field, and then we bow up and make a stop down there in the red zone. But we're a beat-up football team. The open week's coming at the right time. Rico Dowdle's got a fibula fracture exactly like Debo Samuel and Kelsey Crosby. It's absolutely amazing. I've never been around anything like this before. Chad Terrell's got a little bit of a sprained ankle. Other than that, we're just really beat up. Zach Bailey probably could have played in an emergency today, so he definitely will be up for our next ball game. Corey Helms will definitely be back for our next ball game. Malik Young, we feel like, is going to be back for our next ball game. Terry Bieber should be back for our next ball game. I'm uncertain on Chad right now, but I think it's probably just a 10 or 12 day thing. But Rico will be done for an extended time, so I hate that for that young man. The first time he's really been healthy these last 2 weeks, so getting him back was huge for us. But Mon Denson did a fantastic job of stepping in there. AJ made some tough runs. Tyson made some tough runs. So we had some guys step up. But again, our guys continued to fight. It wasn't always good in the first half, especially on the defensive side of the ball. It's not very crisp in our tackling. Frustrated with that, but I think they had about 150 yards in the first quarter. They ended up with 250, probably 80 yards in the last drive. So we took over the game in the second half, and I'll open up for any questions.
What tell your guys on the last series down there at the goal line? What were you telling them for the timeouts? What were you looking for?
Well, really, more than anything, I feel we work a lot in the red zone as far as pick routes and different things. They did a nice job trying to set up on the previous play where they only ran 2.5 seconds off the clock on the play, which is the first time I've ever seen that. They did the fake pick and worked back outside. Rashad Finn did a fantastic job, and Jamarcus worked himself in the phase. And then they ran a pick on the goal line, which everybody does, and Chris Lamont made a fantastic play to work through it. Stay locked in coverage. We got good pressure on the play, so it was I think a lot. You credit our players because we work a lot down there. They understand about the things that people are going to do to you down there. You credit our defensive staff, Tavares Robinson, Lance Thompson, Coleman Hudson, Mike Peterson. Those guys do a fantastic job.
Well, what was the defensive adjustment really going into the second quarter? It seemed like you guys just really locked down on them.
I mean, the one stretch play to our sideline, I mean, I counted 6 missed tackles at the point of attack. The ball cuts back. I mean, they just circled the defense. I guess it was about a 40-yarder. John Kelly runs hard. He's a good player. He ran through jam on their sideline for about a 25-yarder. The quarterback extended a couple plays for him on third down, a couple plays on second down. I mean, there was nothing that schematically we looked at and thought, wow, we're getting beat here. We wanted to be a little firmer on our edges because we felt like it was more of an edge run game, and that was really about the only thing we really talked about defensively.
What did you guys see in the second half that allowed you to suddenly start running the football?
Well, we felt like some of the divide zone stuff really worked well for us as far as dividing the flow. We cut the ball inside a good bit, and we made better cuts at the running back position. The RPOs were very effective for us, which I think loosened them up. I do think some of the shots early in the game loosened them up. We loosened them up outside to know that, hey, on the first play of the game, we're going to take a shot on them, and we're going to continue to do that. So those are things that we've got to continue to do. But, again, our guys made it. We got to credit Kurt Roper and Eric Wolford and Bobby Bentley and Pat Washington and Brian McClendon. Those guys did a fantastic job at halftime. Not a whole lot was going good at the time. We get a 4th-and-1 stop. They get a field goal really before half, and you go in there and we make some adjustments. And so I was really proud of how we responded.
Will was one of those offensive adjustments to start attacking the edges more so the middle would open up?
Yeah, we did get the rocket sweeps and those things. We've got to continue to tour. Ain't no doubt.
Well, what about all the big plays on defense for the second week in a row?
What's that?
All the big plays on defense for the second week in a row.
We didn't get any turnovers, did we?
No, but I mean sacks.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. I mean, we got to get pressure. We're having a hard time manufacturing a 4-man rush. And we had a third down. It was a really nice call by T-Rob. He brought field pressure. We got pressure off the edge to track the quarterback down. I do think we did get some good 4-man rush as far as those things are concerned. He's mostly a one-read guy. If it's not there, he's going to pull it and run it. We saw that after the first series. So we needed to be able to leave a rat. rat in the hole in a lot of situations, a spy on him. We did that more than we've ever done. So, I mean, there were some things that I thought adjustment-wise we did do a nice job of in the game. But there's no question some momentum plays in the game that we were able to make was really a huge part of that.